Does moving average strategy even work? Are all online trading gurus telling you fake information? Well, I have wasted years testing every trading strategy out there before I found the right one that worked. I have created this channel to expose every strategy and show their real probabilities so you don't have to waste your precious time like I did. I'm not here to sell any kind of online courses. I'm just here to help you in your stock market trading career. So in this channel, I will be backtesting 100 times all the famous trading strategies. Yes, you heard it right. Testing 100 times will surely take time and most likely prove if you should risk your hard-earned money using this strategy. You might have seen such videos in YouTube, but in all those videos, results are focused on Forex market. And in India, more than 70% of traders trade in stock market only. So the result will be different from that. To test these strategies in Indian share market, I will be testing the trade in 4 stocks of Nifty 50. Because majority of people only trade in Nifty stocks for their volumes. As you can see, I have selected Reliance and IOC, which has highest and lowest weightage in Nifty stocks, while Tata Steel and Adani Port can represent stock in the between. So basically, by testing these stocks, we can get a better idea if the strategy really works in an Indian market or is it a trash. So hi everyone, this is Pranit from Trader Insight. So let's start the video. So this is how it's going to work. I'm going to be using 3 EMAs. Those who are new to EMA stands for Exponential Moving Average. EMA basically gives Exponential Moving Average price of a stock for a defined number of days and plot it into a chart. As you can see here, green one, this will be a fast moving average, that is 9 days EMA. The red one is my slow moving average, which is a 21 day EMA. I'm also going to be using a white one, which is a 200 day EMA. This EMA shows the long term trend of the stocks and can help us to filter fake signals. So when green EMA crosses red from below, it's a buy signal. And when red EMA crosses green one from the below, it's a sell signal. I'm going to be setting up my stop loss at the nearest swing low or swing high from where the cross happened. For example, this crossed up and my entry was right here at the close of the candle. My stop loss will be placed below this most recent low of the long position. For the risk to reward ratio, I'm going to be setting up the stop, then I'm going to be aiming for 1.5. That's how it's going to look. So for this trade, it would be a winner. The only thing here is that when that crossover is above the 200 EMA, you can only go long. And if the cross is below the 200 EMA, then you can only go short. So I think now the strategy is clear. Let's get started. I'm gonna fast forward through 100 tests and I'll let you know the full results. So I completed the back testing of the 4 stocks for 100 times, that is 25 times per stock, and here is the complete report. My average risk reward ratio was around 1.5, max risk was 1% per position, total number of trade was 100, won 56 trade and lost 44 trade. For such a simple strategy, results are quite impressive. as you can see, my winning ratio is 56%. Total gain in account was 48.72%, and max drawdown was just minus 5.85%. You can also see the equity curve and drawdown curve. Continuous win in a row was around 8, and continuous loss in a row was around 6. Total duration required for the testing was around 7 months. So as you can see, once the strategy is optimized with other strategies, it can be quite profitable. Also, another thing, please backtest this strategy yourself and come to the conclusion. This strategy is not a recommendation. This is only for an educational purpose only. Please support us by subscribing to the channel and hitting the bell notification and like the video. All the social media and Patreon links will be in the description. Please follow us and show your support. More awesome content are on the way. See you next time.